Today, I would like to open up a prayer for you before we start. So, bago tayo mag-start, you can share this link to your friends, to your family, so that sabay-sabay tayong mabless lahat. Thank you, thank you. So, let us pray. Father God, we are thanking you for today. Thank you for this powerful word that you have prepared for us. Let this word manifest in our lives, that it will take root in our heart. Open our minds, open our ears into your fresh revelation today. Let your anointing flows. Kahit, Lord, sa online ito, we believe, Lord, there's no limit in what you can do. There's no limit in your power. So thank you, Lord, for the manifestation of this word today, for the glory of your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Thank you for praying with me. So, last Sunday, in Powerhouse Church, no, Pastor John shared Nehemiah, where he was rebuilding the walls of Jerusalem. I was inspired of that preaching because it tells us that whatever the vision God gives us, we already have provision. Diba? So the moment you obey and focus on his instructions, there would be undoubted, undeniable miracles that will happen in your life. Imagine rebuilding the walls in just 52 days. That was God who was with them. So kung ano man ang gustong i-build ni God sa buhay mo, kaya niyang gawin yan in an instant. Allow Him to do it for you. So sabi ko, Lord, kung si Nehemiah nag-build, ano kaya yung pwede kong i-share? Because we want to occupy. We want to occupy social media. We want to occupy every territories that we can have. So that's why we are always online. So as I go through, no, in my sleep, the Holy Spirit revealed this to me. So if Nehemiah started rebuilding walls in Jerusalem, the impression to me is that we have to destroy naman. And this is the walls of Jericho. Oh, ready na ba kayong mag-destroy? Ano ba yung mga i-destroy natin? Siguro nag-iisip kayo, anong di-destroy ko? No? Siguro nag-iisip kayo, ano ba yung i-destroy natin? Ito yung mga walls or strongholds sa buhay natin na seemingly parang di na magbabago. Like mga addictions, mga problema, financial difficulties, losses, rebellious children, health challenges. So, just to have this encouraging word, spoiler alert, we can destroy these barriers, these walls in our lives. So, yan. Ready ka na ba? Ready ka na ba? Sabi mo nga sa comment, I am ready to destroy these walls. So, let us destroy it together. No? So, as I was reading Joshua chapter 6, verse 1, sabi niya, now the gates of Jericho were securely barred because of the Israelites. No one went out and no one came in. And I'm reading in an NIV version. So, there would be times when you feel like you are surrounded by challenges and problems in your life. Yung mga problema, paulit-ulit na lang na hindi mo talaga malabasan. Yung kahit pamilya mo, hindi ka matulungan. So, everything is as if shut down. Minsan, parang gusto mo na sumuko, ayaw mo na. But here it goes in verse 2, no? We are still reading in Joshua chapter 6. And right now, I'm reading in the Message translation. It says, God spoke to Joshua, "Look sharp now. I've already given Jericho to you, along with its king and its elite forces. Here's what you are to do. March around the city, all your soldiers, circle the city once, repeat this for 6 days, have 7 priests carry 7 ram's horn trumpets in front of the chest. On the 7th day, march around the city 7 times, the priests blowing away on the trumpets, and then a long blast on the ram's horn when you hear that. All the people are to shout at the top of their lungs. The city wall will collapse at once. All the people are to enter, every man straight on in. And that's Joshua chapter 6, verse 2 to 5 in the Message translation. So when you have a relationship with Jesus, it will be easy for you to hear instructions on how to resolve the challenges or problems. Maraming pagkakataon, nag-a-ask tayo kay Daddy God na tanggalin tayo sa problema na meron tayo or tanggalin niya ang mga problema sa buhay natin. Where in fact, you already have the authority and power to resolve any situation or problems or challenges in your life. Dito, si Joshua binigyan ng instruction ni Daddy God, and just like Joshua, we can only have that kind of instruction if we have time to hear. Sabi niya dito sa verse na to, God said, I've already given you Jericho. Anong ibig sabihin nito? Binigay ko na ang solusyon. Nandyan na ang blessing, ang provision, ang health, ang relationship. And here's what you need to do. No? Napaka-specific ng bilang ni Daddy God dito. See, sabi niya, march around for 6 days. 6 days, ikot-ikot lang tayo. Tayo ba kaya nating gawin yon? At times, we want to resolve everything now. Kaya nagiging magulo lalo or worse, nafufrustrate ka or nadidisappoint. So you know, you have to make sure ano man ang pinagagawa sa'yo ni Daddy God, there's a purpose in it. You have to trust and keep moving. Do what you got to do. Even if the problem is in front of you, you can still have joy, you can still have peace, you can still have provision, you can still have solution. Amen? So, mag-amen yung mga nag-agree dyan. Amen? 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 So, in Joshua chapter 6, we're going to chapter 6, and to verse 7, in the Message translation, sabi niya, so Joshua, son of Nun, called the priest and told them, take up the chest of the covenant. 7 priests are to carry 7 ram's horn trumpets, leading God's chest. Then he told the people, set out, march around the city, have the armed guard march before the chest of God. So, sino ang nasa harapan sa pagmamarch? Yung Ark of Covenant, di ba? With the priest, right? In the New Covenant, when you receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, you already have the Ark of Covenant inside of you. Kasama mo siya, saan ka pumunta, ano man ang ginagawa mo, ikaw na ang King Priest. Yun ang sabi niya sa 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 9. But you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's special possession, that you may declare the praises of Him who called you out of darkness into His wonderful light. So, ibig sabihin, you can march and fight these challenges and problems in your life kasi tinapos na ni Jesus. No? You don't fight for victory. You fight from victory. You are fighting from victory from what Jesus did. So, sabi nga niya dito sa Joshua chapter 6 pa rin tayo, no? And that's gonna be in verse 10 to 11. But Joshua commanded the army, do not give a war cry. Do not raise your voices. Do not say a word until the day I tell you to shout. Then shout. So he had the ark of the Lord carried around the city, circling at once. Then the army returned to camp and spent the night there. And then sabi niya pa sa verse, that's NIV version ah. And then sa the Message translation says, Joshua had given orders to the people. Don't shout. In fact, don't even speak. Not so much as a whisper until you hear me say. So sabi ni Joshua, don't shout. Don't speak. In NIV and in the Message translation, do not give war cry. Huwag kayong sumigaw. Huwag kayong magsalita. Kapag nasa harapan ka ng problema, no? Kapag nasa harapan ka na ng problema, do not complain. Huwag mong i-magnify ang problem. Do not magnify the problem. If you can't say anything that would come out of your mouth, sabi nga ni Daniel Padilla, shut up ka na lang. So, do not speak defeat. Do not speak negative words. Instead, speak blessings, speak favor, speak provision, speak peace, speak health. That is what the person who knows exactly what Jesus did on the cross. You are fighting from victory. So, kahit ano pang nangyayari sa paligid mo, you still speak blessing, you still speak favor. Or kung hindi mo kaya, huwag ka nang magsalita. Huwag ka nang mag-speak ng defeat, huwag ka mag-speak ng negative words, or huwag ka nang mag-speak ng complain, because it will not help. Amen? Amen? Do you agree with me? Yes? So, going to Joshua chapter 6, verse 15, when the seventh day came, they got up early and marched around the city, the same way, but seven times. Yes, this day, they circled the city seven times. On the seventh time around, the priest blew the trumpets and Joshua signaled the people. Shout! God has given you the city. The city and everything in it is under a holy curse and offered up to God. That is in the Message translation, no? So here, maaga silang tumayo, umikot ng seven times, and shouted. Ikaw nga, bigay mo na nga yung biggest shout mo dyan, kahit nasan ka pa. Give your best shout right now. Comment mo, hallelujah, hallelujah. Comment down below, no? Same thing as yung kung ano man ang mga sitwasyon or challenges na sa buhay mo, ikutan mo. And shout your highest hallelujah as if na-resolve na. Shout your heart out. Sabi naman ni Daddy God, I have given you Jericho. Binigay na niya sa'yo lahat. Pagpupuri mo na lang hinihintay para ma-occupy mo ang territory na binibigay ni Daddy God sa'yo. Your praise is your breakthrough. Your praise is your deliverance. Your praise is your healing. Your praise is your provision. Kaya praise, praise, praise. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Sagot mo dyan, i-comment mo. Praise, praise, praise. No? Kaya nga, dito, when I got through Joshua chapter 6, verse 17, except for Rahab the harlot, she is to live, she and everyone in her house with her because she hid the agents we sent. So, ito sa verse na to, no? Si Rahab the harlot, tumulong kina Joshua on the previous chapters when they spiked the city before they march around. May mga tao na gagamitin si Lord sa buhay mo na seemingly they're not qualified. But you know, God can bless you using these people and in return, they will be blessed and be saved because of you. No? So in chapter 20, we're still in Joshua. Kapit lang kayo, huwag kayong naalis. We're still in Joshua chapter 6, verse 20. The priest blew the trumpets. Ito na. No? When the people heard the blast of trumpets, they gave a thunderclap shout. The wall fell at once. The people rushed straight into the city and took it. So, alam mo yun, thunderclap shout. Yung... when you praise and give the highest praise, sabi thunderclap, dumadagundong talaga. No? Dito sa praise mo, using only your hands, by clapping, by shouting, your problems, strongholds, addictions, bondages, financial difficulties, health problems, it will fall at once. Lahat! Walang matitira. Lahat! Not only the wall fell, but the whole city fell, sabi niya. So, walang imposibleng pwedeng gawin si Daddy God sa buhay mo. Kaya niyang baguhin ang buhay mo in an instant. Sabi nga niya dito, in just 7 days. Just shout your hallelujah and people will see how you overcome those challenges in your life. So, ngayon pa lang, no? Kung di mo pa ginawa to sa tanang buhay mo, it's about time. It's never too late, no? Ngayon pa lang, I prophesy to you, in the next 7 days, as you shout your hallelujah to God, you will see those chains, strongholds, problems sa pera, sa pamilya, sa health, it will fall down in the name of Jesus. You will be released from them all. Amen? You will see your breakthrough and you will occupy all the blessings God has given you. You will occupy territories by sharing your powerful testimonies to them. So, anong dapat mong gawin? Let God's word settle the truth about your situation. Amen? Amen? I declare right now, every long-standing addiction, destructive or negative habit pattern will be defeated. I declare those things that those strongholds and at times look unbreakable will now break down as we step into your breakthrough. I declare that every chain that has ever imprisoned us in falling to the floor, releasing us to move forward boldly without looking back into a new era of unprecedented freedom so we can occupy in Jesus' name. No, with God's conquering peace firmly tied to your mind and emotions, you will be empowered to keep marching ahead, impervious of the devil's attempt to take you down. So let's move this year, letting go of the past, old mindset, limited thinking, hurts, and pains. Let's move forward with boldness, opening up our hearts, widening and occupying territories, expanding our tents for the sake of God to do great things in our lives. Let's all marvel to His goodness. Let's praise Him as we move forth and occupy from glory to glory. Amen? Amen? I'm joining us. And just like what we shared, you can also conquer all those problems and challenges or strongholds in your life. Yung addiction man yan or right now, you can have the opportunity. Just pray this prayer with me. Sabihin mo siya, huwag kang mahiya sa katabi mo. Sabihin mo to, Lord Jesus, thank you for your word. I admit that I'm a sinner and in need of a Savior. I believe Romans chapter 10 verse 9 that if I declare with my mouth that Jesus is my Lord and I believe in my heart that God raised Him from the dead, I will be saved. So right now, I invite you to be my Lord and Savior. Give me a new heart in Jesus' name. Amen. So by that simple prayer, sabi nga niya sa John chapter 1 verse 12, but those who embraced Him and took hold of His name were given authority to become the children of God. So right now, you can conquer everything. You can destroy those barriers, those strongholds in your life. You will see the goodness of God in your life starting today. So thank you for joining us. I would like to give a prayer to everyone. Lord, we are praying for each and everyone right now who are listening, tuning in right now to our live service. So Lord, bless them, Lord. Let the manifestation of this word be in their hearts, be in their minds, and be in their lives. And we would like to give glory to you, Lord. Bless them, O Lord, those who need provision right now, those who need healing right now, those who need restoration, deliverance, Lord. We are praying for each and every one of them. So thank you, Lord, for your glory and for your power. We give you honor and praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen. So thank you for joining us tonight. Thank you for your time today. Keep sharing the word and let's occupy territories today and this year so you will be blessed and be an extended blessing. Bye!